Hello and welcome to my kitchen. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make chole or a Sindhi style chickpea curry. This curry goes really well with pattura or with bread and is eaten like for breakfast in India. It's a very popular dish. It's vegan and it's full of protein. So let's get cooking. You'll need 1 cup or 200 grams of dried white chickpeas, 1/2 teaspoon of salt and 2 cups of water for boiling the chickpeas, 5 tablespoons of oil, 2.5 cups or 300 grams of chopped onions. This works out to 1.5 large onions chopped up. 1 400-gram tin of plum tomatoes, 2 teaspoons of coriander cumin powder, 1 teaspoon of roasted and ground cumin powder, 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric, 1/2 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 pinch of dried fenugreek leaves or kasturi methi, 2 teaspoons of fresh chopped ginger, and 2 to 4 green chilies depending on how hot you like it. And 2 teaspoons of tomato puree and 2 teaspoons of tamarind concentrate to counteract the sweetness of the onions. The first thing we're going to do is to rinse the dried chickpeas and wash them under running water. Then we're going to soak them overnight in plenty of water because the dried chickpeas will absorb a lot of the water. Make sure there's plenty of water in there and let them soak overnight. Then the following morning, drain all the water and give the chickpeas a quick rinse. Then look over them and remove any chickpeas that you see that have like black spots on them or that don't look good. Then put all the chickpeas into your Instant Pot or pressure cooker, add 2 cups of water and 1/2 teaspoon of salt and put them on to boil under pressure for 20 minutes. While my chickpeas are boiling in my Instant Pot, I'm going to start frying the onions. So I have a good sized pan here and I'm going to put it on to heat on a medium heat. Let the pan heat up for a few minutes and then add the oil. Then once the oil's heated up for a few minutes, add the onions. Now we want these onions to cook to a nice golden brown color, so make sure your heat isn't too high. Mine's on 7 right now, but I'm gonna reduce it to 6. While your onions are cooking, blend up your tomatoes and the ginger and the chilies in your blender. I'm using my Blendtec. Now my onions are starting to get some color, so I'm actually going to reduce the heat down to the number 4 and let them cook on a lower heat. Be sure to keep stirring the onions so that they don't get burnt. And when they are a lovely golden color, then add the tomatoes. And add the remaining spices. Now we're going to let the spices cook together for a couple of minutes. In the meantime, my Instant Pot has pressurized for 20 minutes and it's turned itself off, and we're going to let the pressure release naturally. So the tomatoes and the spices have been cooking in here for a few minutes and the oil is starting to come up onto the top, and that's what we're looking for. The trick to making a really good chickpea curry, a Sindhi chole curry, is frying the onions slowly and letting the masala, the spices, cook together slowly. So this is a good point for me to turn off the heat and let this sit because I want the pressure to release naturally. So I'm gonna let this sit with the lid on. So my heat is off and I'm just gonna cover it with a lid. Now the pressure has released from my Instant Pot, so I'm just gonna open the pressure cooker and check my chickpeas are cooked completely. So they're cooked perfectly. I am gonna remove some of the scum that's sitting on top. This white foamy stuff, I don't want that in my curry, so I'm just gonna remove that. Then I'm going to heat up my tomato spice mix again on a medium heat. And then once it's simmering, I'm going to add the chickpeas and the water to the mix. Then I'm going to cover this and let it simmer for a good 15 minutes or so. And then we'll add the tomato puree and the tamarind paste. So my chickpeas have been simmering for a good 15 minutes and now I'm gonna add the tomato puree and the tamarind paste. Once you've added the tamarind paste and the tomato paste, give it a good stir and we're gonna let it cook for a good 15-20 minutes again because we want those elements to cook in the sauce. The tomato paste and the tamarind paste will really help make this curry really nicely rounded because the onions are sweet and the tamarind and the tomatoes are kind of citrusy, so it gives a very slight citrusy flavor to it. And it helps thicken the sauce a little bit too. But if you want a thicker sauce, you can crush up some of the chickpeas and just crush them up in there and that will help thicken the sauce. Now I'm happy with the consistency and the texture and the taste of my curry, so I'm gonna turn off the heat. I like to make the chickpea curry a few hours before we're ready to eat because I like the curry to sit there and the flavors to meld together. So my chickpea curry is ready and I'm gonna serve it in a bowl. Sprinkle a little bit of coriander on that. And it tastes really good with onion rings, so I'm gonna put a couple of onion rings on there. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you all soon for some more cooking inspiration. So good. Oh, that is amazing. Sweet, sour, amazing. It's so good. It's so good.